Imagine if you'd never had to mow your lawn again. Well, that's exactly what this product claims it can do for you. This is called the Gardena Sileno, and it's a brand new robotic lawnmower that claims it'll do the work for you. And in this video, we're gonna put that claim to the test, check out the features, and install this mower to see if it can make the cut. If you order a Sileno, keep in mind they come in several sizes to fit the size of your yard. It's kind of like a small, medium, and a large. Now this is their model 500, and this is their mid-sized unit. And this model is designed with the homeowner in mind so that you can do the entire installation yourself. In fact, everything you need is right inside this one box. Robotic lawnmowers are smart, but they don't know everything, and that's exactly why you need this wire. It acts like an invisible fence to make sure that the robot mower stays on your lawn exactly where you want it. And when it's done mowing, it goes back to this base to recharge automatically. And installing the wire can be a lot easier than you think. In fact, I did this entire front yard in just about an hour and a half. And you don't have to bury the wire, you can actually put it right on top of the grass. But the first step in the directions is actually pretty easy. You need to set up that base, and this will typically be right off the lawn. Now, I like this spot on my bed, but unfortunately, there's a real height difference between the lawn and the bed itself. But fortunately, this was a simple problem to solve. I just placed a couple of bricks underneath the base, and then everything finally lined up. Now, the mower itself runs on a lithium-ion battery, but the base itself needs electricity, so you will need an outlet nearby. Now I can place the mower into the base to let the battery charge up and to get the mower itself set up. Now fortunately this model was pretty easy, you just answer some questions in the menus, then you're ready to move on to the next step, which is installing the boundary wire around your lawn. Installing the boundary wire is actually easier than you would think because of these stakes. All you need to do is lay the wire right on top of your lawn and then hammer these stakes in and it'll hold the wire down. And I know you're thinking that wire is going to look horrible, but within about 2 to 3 weeks, the grass will grow on top of the wire and you won't see it at all. Now you do want to think about the future if you ever plan to use an aerator or a rake, you could tear that wire up. But for most people that are getting a robot mower, this is going to be the simplest and the fastest way to do the installation. And if your lawn isn't very formal and you don't have any beds like this, you don't even need to use that included ruler. You could just go ahead and run the boundary wire around your lawn and call it done. But in my case, I've got beds and I want to mow as close to the edge as possible without the machine falling into them. And that's what that ruler is for. It's a guide. It actually has measurements that tell you exactly how far to keep that wire from the edge of a bed or something like a stone wall. Kira and I completed this entire installation in just about an hour and a half. And considering when you're done, you may never have to mow your lawn again, it's definitely well worth the time.
Maybe go a little closer to that bed. A little bit. There you go. Perfect.
And this can really be a great project to do with your kids.
Is this easy?
Not at all.
And when you're done with the boundary wires, they plug right into the back of the base, and the LED should go from blue to green, and that means everything's installed correctly, and you're ready to mow. You've got two ways to control this mower. There's a built-in control panel on the top of the mower itself, or you can run it completely through the wireless app they include for free. You can set up a schedule. You can even have this thing mow at night. All robotic mowers are quiet, but this is one of the quietest on the market. In fact, they claim it's the quietest model you can get. You don't really hear the motor at all, you just hear this light sound of the grass blades being cut. That's another key difference with all robotic mowers. They're not designed to cut an inch or two off your grass at a time. Robot mowers can cut as little as a 16th of an inch off every time they mow, but the difference is they're going to mow every day or every other day, so this way your lawn never actually gets long, and it kind of just looks cut all the time. But just to show you that even a small unit like this has some power, you can see by the clippings I was actually cutting off about 1 inch at a time here. Now that's not typically ideal, but it does show you this thing has a lot more power than you might have thought. And you can adjust the cutting height on this model really easily. You just flip up the door on top, turn that knob to the setting you want, and it raises or lowers the cutting deck below. Another big difference with the Sileno is it could handle slopes and rough terrain. Now my front lawn isn't horrible, but I've got roots and ruts and all kinds of bumps. This thing didn't have any issues and it never got hung up on any of them. And the other huge advantage with this model was the ability to handle the slope. Now in the front of my yard, this is about 20 to 30 degrees, and this model had no problem at all climbing up or down that slope. And if you've got a walkway like this, you can put that boundary wire right up to it because the mower's not going to get caught up on anything, and that will allow it to cut right over the bricks. So that means you won't have to trim it after the job is done. If you've got trees or any other obstructions to the yard, or the mower hits something, this is exactly what it'll do. That front bumper moves, and then it basically tells the mower to back off and turn in another direction. From up above, you can see the pattern that this mower leaves, and this is pretty much how all these robotic mowers work, and the pattern looks crazy, but from ground level, you don't really notice it. This lawnmower only weighs about 10 pounds, so it's not putting a lot of pressure on your grass. So about an hour or two after you're done mowing, all the lines are basically gone and it just looks even. For the most part, these robot mowers are maintenance free, but this one has a couple of advantages. It uses the same three blade design as other models, and these are basically just like small razor blades. Now, you might not think those could cut anything, but those will cut your entire lawn. They're cheap and they're actually simple to replace. And the reason they look loose like that is the design that if they hit something like a stick or a rock, they will just fold back. But when they hit grass, they have no problem at all cutting it. Another big difference with this model is you clean it by hosing it off, and it's not just on top, you can flip it over and spray all the grass clippings off the bottom. Robot mowers aren't for everybody, and if you love mowing your lawn, you're definitely not going to want to get one of these, but there's a lot of people that don't and would like to automate this part of their life similar to using a Roomba that keeps their house clean. But they do have some downsides, and the first is the price. Now, the retail on this model is $9.99, so that's not cheap by any stretch, but if it saves you buying a mower or potentially hiring somebody else to cut the grass, it might actually pay for itself over time. But most people are going to pick this just for the fact that their lawn looks cut all the time, and they don't have to do it themselves. And either way, I hope you found this video interesting, and if you did, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you're not already for more videos coming up.